show kind of came out of, you know, an interest that I have in the way that the artists develop their practice and the in-betweenness of that development. This exhibition is actually, it's called One Way or Another Two because there was a One Way and Another One. Three of the artists from that show are the ones who've been selected for this show. Sarah, Lewis and Eric and myself, we've all, over the years, have continued to have a dialogue with each other about our practice. We have a kind of natural rapport when we talk about our work. We're all very interested in the process and discussing the various stages of the work and development.
In this show, I'm showing some sculptural work and some
Tweedos.
Tweedos, yes. Well, I've got two different things here that are related, and Leslie put the show together as a set of ideas of things that we've been making that perhaps we might not necessarily exhibit that have been influential in other parts of our practice.
I'd spoken with Lewis about his piece, The Bow, quite a lot. And he'd spoken about The Bow, and I'd spoken about the shrine piece that's at the back of me here. I realised after talking to Lewis and he talking about The Bow that it was important to have something sitting there as a kind of unfinished almost. And I kind of think artists create these kind of maybe objects that have characteristics of a kind of transitional objects that allow them to think and imagine the place they're at into a different space.
That kind of sums up really some of the excitement of doing a show like this. It's the things that normally don't get considered and formally presented. So to actually have this arrangement to see things kind of in progress or sort of testing things is actually, you know,
I think that idea of testing things is interesting. You bring them all together and you see how they work, and it is about, you know, the imagination and what, you know, what you use to kind of make a set of ideas and where you draw a line when something partly finished or not.
Yes, maybe that's what
it needed to come out of the studio, and now it has. So maybe that's its life. You know, maybe it's complete. I'll think about it a bit.
I had a show with Smart last summer. From there, Sally and I had a conversation, and she mentioned that she would be looking to program something in the Smart Gallery, which was related to process. And so Sally invited me to and invite some other artists that I thought would kind of work with that.
When I originally saw the photographs that Leslie had sent about the space, I was really excited about it. It's incredibly beautiful in terms of a space to show it. And one of the things that attracted me to it was showing the plates and showing ceramics. I'm always holding in the back of my mind a kind of the idea of domestic objects. So for me, showing in a gallery space, which is like a kind of living room, it again kind of echoes something. Within the room there's skirting board, there's windows, there's shutters.
But also, you know, just this piece here of informal education actually being placed, I mean, I could never have said, oh yes, I'd like those works placed in the middle of a fireplace in any convincing way, but actually it's fixed at the moment because it's actually framed by the kind of architecture of being in here. Interestingly, when you actually bring things into a gallery space, that's a point in time, so there's a sort of sense of being fixed. It feels very resolved. It's like somehow, even though things might be still in progress or kind of being thought through.
I did have a sort of kind of strong notion of how they would work in space. I hoped there would be a kind of harmony between the works, and that's what went well actually. So I thought maybe there might be a couple of pieces that might jar a bit, but that, you know, that's not happened. I think they work really well.